and then those sad, rainy, and cloudy days. And on those bright and sunny days, you need to realize how bright they really are. And on those sad, rainy, and cloudy days, you need to be able to find a silver lining and then be brighter than that. This is what an optimist does, and this is the kind of person that everyone wants to surround themselves with. So why not that person be you? Throughout this presentation, I want to encourage you guys to stay optimistic, think positive, and kind of just keep an open mind and try and find the silver lining in every situation before I tell you. So when you're defining someone who's an optimist and who has a silver lining, Judy Belmont did a research. She is a psychologist and she graduated from the University of Pennsylvania. And she believes someone who has found their silver lining is someone who is a great communicator and they find the possibilities in every situation. And they don't let their fears interfere with their lifestyle, and they definitely smile a lot. And they don't blame others for their problems, and they're definitely not victims of life. So a situation where I was definitely being a pessimist and not having the characteristics of someone who can find their silver lining was in seventh grade during the Civil War project. My group partners and I, we all started assigning each other's tasks, and then immediately we just started disagreeing and arguing, and we all were fighting, and it just became so stressful, and everyone just lost their drive to do any work whatsoever. And this ultimately ended up in losing each other's friendships. And so this is when we realized we need to take a step back and we need to realize how are we going to become positive about the situation. And this is when I came up with the two-step plan to positive thinking. So the first step is finding your motive. You need to find a drive or a passion to think positive, because if you don't have a drive, how can you give positive thinking an honest chance? So in order to find your motivation, you need to ask yourself this question. Why do you want to? Why do you want to try positive thinking? My mentor was Ms. Broaddus. She is a fourth grade English teacher at the Oak Ridge School. And when I asked her this question, I asked her, what is your motivation? How do you come to school every day? And how are you continuously smiling? And she said, well, my motivation is my faith. And she lives by a Bible verse, which is Romans 8:28. This is her motivation piece, and this is how she's continuously positive every day. And so then once you find your motivation, the second step is finding your strategy. So you need to find your game plan of how you're going to pull out your positive mindset. And so there are many different ways you could go about this. You can savor life's joys, enjoy the little things. You can forgive those that maybe don't do something very nice to you, and you can thank those that help you. And also a very intriguing or interesting strategy is writing down your thankfuls when you're having a bad day. So a situation where I had to find my strategy was when I found out I was moving to Boston. I was super sad inside because I knew I was going to move away from all my friends and my family. I mean, I'm moving halfway across the country, and it was just a very pessimistic situation for me. So this is when I realized I need to do my two-step plan. So my motivation was to become excited about moving to Boston, and then my strategy was to write down my thankfuls. And so when I wrote down my thankfuls, I realized, wow, there's going to be a lot of great opportunities for me in Boston. I'm going to get to have so many new experiences that I would have otherwise never had, and I'm going to get to meet so many new people, and of course I'll probably see more than 3 inches of snow. So this is when I found my strategy, and I am super excited to move to Boston. But Ms. Broaddus and I are not the only ones that have had the two-step plan actually work. Oprah Winfrey is another great success story of positive thinking working. Her motivation is to help her fans be very optimistic, and her strategy is her entertainment. She spreads her optimism through her entertainment, through her magazines and her old Oprah Winfrey show and things like that. And of course it must be working because she's like a billionaire. So some obstacles that you might run into when you're trying to do the two-step plan is, yes, it is going to be hard to make the change, and it's probably going to take a lot of time, and you're really going to have to think every time in every situation where you're kind of being pessimistic. And you're probably saying, Maya, this is going to be impossible. But I promise if you stick to the two-step plan rubrics, that over time all these obstacles will kind of just become a habit. And then once this habit has been arose, you're going to start having self-drive from within, and you're going to be able to cope in harder situations in an easier form. And also you're going to be stressless, so then you'll have more drive to do your things. And then also you're going to just feel better mentally and physically. So my results from the two-step plan was I got a solid A+ on my Civil War project, and we restored our friendships that we had beforehand. And I am super excited to move to Boston. quote from Helen Keller says, "Keep facing the sun so you don't see the shadows." You now have a way to think positive, and you now know how to think positive. And you now know how to find a silver lining. So why not try and be brighter than that? Thank you.